episode of The Friendship Stop. We are your hosts for today's show. I'm Bryson.
And I am Noah. In our show, we want to highlight the students and the work in our audio.
I got caught on my tongue. Welcome to this episode of The Friendship Stop. We're your hosts for today's show. I'm Bryson.
And I am Noah. In our show, we want to highlight the student and the work in our audio video production class at Friendship 9th Grade Center. So, let us get things started with a look at some of the fun projects we have completed this year.
Do you know that guy?
I have to go to the restroom.
Something new we are currently learning is how to find, develop, capture, and edit feature stories, and we want to show them off. So let us start with Mr. Witt here at our 9th grade center. He is our theater teacher, and this is what his day consists of.
Up next, we have Ms. Garcia. She's a ninth grade English teacher with that level and GT students. Here's what they are doing in her class right now.
So I teach English, both on-level English, and then I also teach the GT English. So the GT classes are for just the gifted and talented students. And so those are students that have either been identified gifted or talented, or there's a couple other options to be able to get into that class. But you have to be approved to be in that class. And it's just an upper level class. It's a lot of focus on making connections between real world events and what we read in class. We look at a lot of different genres and connect them together. And there's also a big emphasis on creativity and upper level thinking. Well, right now we are focusing on poetry. So we're looking at lots of different kinds of poems and how those relate to short stories. And then we're also finishing up our novel, Animal Farm. And we are right now researching, or we're going to research, how the animals in Animal Farm actually are allegories of real people that were key players in the Russian Revolution.
Mr. Singletary, a world geography teacher at the ninth grade center, discusses how COVID-19 has affected his class dynamics.
What I enjoy most about teaching is, educating my kids. I teach world geography, and so a lot of the times kids or people can become very ignorant about cultures outside of their own, and so I enjoy educating my kids on different cultures that they may not experience in their daily life. I actually didn't want to be a teacher growing up. I wanted to be a coach. And I got into the education department at LCU, and they put me in the classroom for a class for an assignment. And once I got in the class, I just loved it. And so I wanted to be a teacher ever since that. COVID's affected us in a way that we can't just normally do what we usually have done on a year-to-year basis. We've had to change some of the different assignments, make sure that some of the stuff is accessible through the internet, through Schoology. We also just can't be as active in like handing out different assignments, different supplies and stuff like that. I mean, we've got to make sure and sanitize everything. We've got to make sure and give space, make sure kids are wearing their masks and stuff like that.
Another perspective is from Mr. Simpson, the principal of the ninth grade center. He goes into detail on how COVID-19 has affected the ninth grade center and how we work together to stay safe.
It's been difficult. I mean, it's definitely been the most challenging year in education that I've had so far. I think that one thing about COVID is making a plan and dealing with making sure that we're keeping kids and students safe. It's the most important part of it. So this is my fourth year as the building principal here at the ninth grade center. I spent 1 year as the associate principal at Friendship High School, and I spent 3 years as an AP. So this is my eighth year total, either as a principal, AP, or the associate. In one way, shape, or form. I love the ninth grade center community. And one thing about this is I interviewed for this job. I chose this job. I wanted to work with ninth grade center students. The majority of the time of my teaching career, I taught ninth grade. And so even though I coached at the varsity level, different sports, but my classroom was always freshmen. And so one thing about freshmen, I feel like that there's 2 years that are very instrumental in a young adult's life. One is their freshman year of high school, and I feel like the other is a freshman year of college. And I think that those 2 years are very instrumental. And so if we can come in, explain and show students how to be successful, and especially the smaller environments that we have here at the ninth grade center, it makes it a lot easier. It's a very small town feel. Very small community feel. All the teachers know each other, And it makes it a lot easier when trying to reach students and get them going down the right track.
Next, we want to join our discussion panel as they talk about the effects of COVID-19 on ninth grade center students.
Hi, and welcome to the panel discussion part of our show. Today we are discussing COVID-19 and its effects on students. Now we will meet our discussion panelists.
Leah Alvarez.
Alize Sierra.
Elian Carmona.
Rachel Forbes.
Noah Hurst.
How has COVID affected students during sports? I would say that it's affected us because we were missing out on lots of sports, and there was stuff that we couldn't do that we wanted to do because we were gone.
I would say it's affected me because, like, it's hard to, like, keep your mask on, but, like, communicate with, like, your friends and playing sports. Like, it's hard to communicate with the coaches, too, because everyone has to wear their masks at all times.
When you were playing sports, the coaches, they have to scream louder than they normally do for us to hear them because we can't hear them with the mask on.
Yeah, and it's hard for everyone. Like, if you're talking to your friend, you have your mask on, but, like, it's hard for them to hear you, too. Like, it's just hard to communicate with others.
Yeah.
So, like, how does it really affect practice?
Or?
I would say, like, it's harder because, like when we all get in, like, a big group to, like, talk about what we're doing, it's harder because we all have to have our masks on instead of, like, the coach just, like, yelling it to us or something.
I feel like it's really dangerous for sports because we don't know any after effects of COVID that could hurt future people doing sports.
Do you think the mask is an inconvenience, like, while you're playing sports or when you're running cross-country?
Hard to wear it, but, like, I mean, I think it's, like, convenient for everyone.
I think it all affects, like, all of us personally, and I was gonna say, like, it helps, like, not it helps us, but, like, it hurts most students because, like, it affects them while they're playing sports and, like, during the school stuff they do. So I was gonna say, like, how has it affected you personally?
Just, like, having to wear the mask at all times, I guess.
I'd say also with everything that's going on in classrooms, again, teachers, it's hard to understand them, and it's hard for teachers to understand the students as well with the masks. So it does make things a little bit harder.
Yeah, like, classes seemed harder with the mask situation. Because you can't be around your teacher if they don't have their mask on or if you don't have it on. Mm-hmm. So, like, asking questions has definitely seemed kind of harder. Like, you could feel the way, like, you could feel how the teacher feels that she doesn't like, or, like, they don't like wearing the mask. Yeah.
Especially in classes where you have to, like, get up and speak, like Spanish or theater, it's kind of difficult.
I mean, masks, like, really, they're not that bad, but they have a lot of things that just are an inconvenience.
How has quarantine affected you?
I mean, when I was in quarantine before school started, so I didn't do much. I just, like, caught up with my family because it had been, like, such a long time since my family had really, like, sat down and talked about what has happened, like, during our week or day. And all I really did was catch up on my summer reading that I had due. So.
Like, during it, most people had to go into the hospital. And they had to, I guess they had to be treated, but, like, there was too many people in the hospital for them to be treated. So there was lots of people who had to get treated, I guess, outside of the hospital.
Yeah, like, if you had an injury of any sort.
Yeah, so I broke my toe, and so, like, it was harder for me to, like, get into the hospital because they had to treat the COVID patients, and, like, the restrictions on wearing your masks was, like, a lot stricter there.
That's all we have for today. Thanks for joining for this portion of the show. And now we will return to our host.
Thanks for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed our show. If you like our show, be sure to follow us on the web at friendship.tv and Facebook. We will see you on the next edition of the F-Stop.